What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Beastie Boys. That's right, I have gotten a copy of License to Ill. I basically heeded the advice and wisdom of the Beasties people. A couple of you had mentioned it would probably make more sense to jump back to License to Ill, get a sense of where they were rhyming in the mid-80s, then go forward and see how far they've come by the time we get to Hello Nasty, I think is the next album after Ill Communication. Correct me if I'm wrong there. But ultimately, yeah, I felt like that was probably the right thing to do, so we jump back. I just got a copy. This is from 1986, though I did get a reissue. Indeed, were CDs like a thing in 86? I was a kid, so I don't really remember. I know I had cassette tapes in the 80s. But yeah, I assume this is at least from the 90s. It just says 86 on here, but as I said, when I looked up the like catalog number or the barcode number on Discogs, what came up was a reissue, so, but it didn't show the year, so I'm not sure. Regardless, the album is from 1986. I'm curious how this will sound relative to the hip-hop tunes I've been listening to from them, which have spanned the period from the late 80s to the mid-90s. I do like the sort of boldness of the art, which maybe now is a bit awkward, but yeah, it's like a cigarette butt, but it's a plane, so it's being like, you know, put out in an ashtray. We're gonna listen to the first track, which is Rhymin and Stealin. You know, it sounds like maybe taking a bar here, taking a bar there, taking a rhyme there, and then kind of like putting it back together as your own. So that's what it makes me think of, the idea of maybe picking up some bars and some tricks of the trade from other people and then sort of, you know, making it into something new, which as a DJ I can say is very much, you know, that's what we do. We sort of find what we like from different places. We, you know, sort of tell a story that we want to tell with the tunes we want to tell in the order that we want to use them. And it becomes like a new story through other people's musical stories. So that's what that makes me think of. Now, it might not have to do that. It might be about like rhyming and actually about, you know, committing larceny, let's say. But we'll have to see. Let's get it. This is Beastie Boys, the first tune on their 1986 album, License to Ill. And it's Rhymin' and Stealin'. Feels like a mixture of like their hardcore stuff.
Nope. They used that phrase in a later track, right?
Correct me if I'm wrong, like that was them on instruments, but there was also some turntablism going on, so I'm just trying to figure out like who's doing what, or I suppose the guitar like could have been sampled in, but like it didn't sound like that. That sounded like, you know, they were on their instruments, but there was also someone at the turntables. And again, I know like the like Mixmaster Mike doesn't come in until much later, and then what's the, oh, I'm forgetting his name. There's like another DJ, but I don't even think he's there yet, so I'm not sure who's on the tables. Do let me know. There was a couple lines about, you know, doesn't shower, so he's always stinking, and made me think that, you know, maybe Del, the funky Homo sapien, you know, heard that line and was like, you know what, I'm gonna make a whole track about that, because I feel like, you know, that is basically the essence of, what's the track on Both Sides of the Brain, shit, I'm blanking on the name. It was actually used in one of the Tony Hawk games, now that I think about it. I think it was the third game? Maybe it was the second game. Either way, yeah, so that line sort of caught my ear. The snare drum in that one, just absolutely, like, explosive. It was like a sonic boom every time the snare hit. So yeah, in a way, it reminds me of, like, you know, some of the hip-hop tracks I've heard from them with the, like, heavy kind of, like, slamming percussive sonics. didn't have the like crazy vocal effect, which I actually enjoyed because I think I heard more of the lines like clearly, you know, not all of them certainly, but I definitely picked up on some of the lines. So yeah, a cool start, interesting to hear like now back in time, because in a way like I'm still trying to like sort through like the evolution of the group in my head and sort of, you know, through the helpful comments from you all, of course, but yeah, sonically I'm still trying to like put the pieces in their places and, you know, try to get a sense of the evolution, which is, again, that was a really, like, smart idea to go back first, and then we'll, like, go forward after this. So, in any case, let me know what you think of this opening tune. Excited to go through the album. I will see you next time.
Peace.